today, so we're relying on yours.
Okay, good.
My notes.
Welcome to the Monday, April 2nd meeting of the Montpelier Design Review Committee. I will let all of the staff and members introduce themselves.
My name is Sarah McShane, and I provide staff assistance.
Liz Pritchett.
Stephen Everett.
Eric Gilbertson.
Hannah Smith.
Theodore Fetter.
Unless anybody has anything to offer before we get going, do I hear a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor of the agenda? Raise your hand. And we can move straight to the first applicant. For anybody who's not been here before, we are advisory to the Development Review Board. We will listen to your application and move it forward to the Development Review Board after our vote. The first applicant is for 73 Main Street, Haney Family LLC, KPH Healthcare. Is anybody here?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead and come forward and have a seat.
I can pull up another chair too.
Describe your new signage.
Okay. So it's for the former Montpelier Pharmacy, putting up new signs for Kenny Drugs.
Can I just get your name?
Stephanie Frost.
Spell your last name.
FROST.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
Ben brought his own cage.
So it's, the name is on that sign panel now, right?
Correct.
It'll be different than.
The only thing that's changed is the name.
Right, I mean, it says Kenny Drugs now.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah, they're coming in for after the fact approval.
Right.
Oh, I see.
Both signs or just the?
The both, yeah. Fact is there as well.
Yeah, I misunderstood.
Yeah.
This was different than what was there now, yeah.
Usually that's a problem when people do that.
Does anybody have any comments, questions regarding the application?
I think it looks fine.
The door sign is the door in the back?
In the rear, yes, yeah.
I think I think it looks better than the Montpelier Pharmacy sign because that was a long, lots of letters, and this is shorter with fewer letters.
Any other comments? I can go through, there's a set of criteria that we use for the design review for signs, and I'll just read down through them.
Okay.
Number 1A, preservation or reconstruction of the appropriate historic style of the proposed projects in the historic district involves an historic structure, acceptable. Harmony of exterior design with other properties in the district, acceptable. Compatibility of proposed exterior materials, acceptable. Prevention of the use of incompatible designs, buildings, color schemes, or exterior materials, acceptable. Compatibility of proposed landscaping is not applicable in this application. Location and appearance of all utilities, no change in the lighting.
Right.
Okay. Acceptable. Recognition of and respect for view corridors and significant vistas, including gateway views of the city and state house. Acceptable. Conformance with city's gate placement and design recommendations. Acceptable. Compatibility with subject property and adjacent properties. Acceptable. Shall not obscure significant architectural details, acceptable. Consistency and uniformity of multiple signs, not applicable. Illumination, not applicable here other than the existing lighting. Pennants and banners prohibited, not applicable. Actually, that's acceptable here because they are not. Individual letters affixed, painted, or engraved directly in the building or structure encouraged. The sign in the sign band is acceptable. All in favor of the application as proposed, raise your hand.
So under our new regulations, signs, your recommendations are just provided to the office and then the permits issued. There's no going to DRB anymore for signs and simple alternatives. alterations, so for this project, your permit will just be issued in the coming days, August 26th, so I imagine.
Okay. Okay.
You can sign that just above my name.
It might take a few days to get it issued, but otherwise it will just come to you in the mail.
So you're free to put it up anytime. You can just hand that back to Peg.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for coming. The next application is 415 Berry Street, Overlake Park. Mr. Cheney, come forward. Is that your, for your protection or ours?
Both. If you're eating at Buddy's, we'll all be protected.
So did you find the dogs?
I did, I found the dogs.
Good.
It was close, but I made it.
Did your dogs take off?
My dogs took off, yes, and so I was calling Sarah in a panic because I was both A, on the committee, and B, presenting, and worried that I wasn't gonna be able to make it, and I was feeling terrible, but here I am.
The dog came home, or you found it?
Oh, I found them, yeah, and they were like, oh yeah, it's just always here, this is fine, and so that was annoying, but.
My son's dog used to run away, but it got more and more, if you just waited, he'd come home.
Yeah, normally they do, but I had to be somewhere, so I was like, you know, trying to be somewhere. Do you guys have paper of what I'm hoping to do?
Yes.
So this is actually, I've been away for the past 2 weeks, so I didn't get to finish this. This is an incomplete application in that I have been asked by Chris Lumbra to also put in a ramp. So in this drawing, it has no ramp. So I guess mostly this is just a, hey, this is an idea that's happening. Any thoughts, comments, suggestions? And then I'll probably have to redo the drawings that show some sort of wheelchair accessible ramp as to how to get into that.
Where
will
the ramp have to go? I mean, do you have an idea of where you are?
Yeah, it feels like as you're entering the building to the left, there's sort of a long sort of space there.
Did you look at the stairs at all to see how they're, they seem like they're not the right rise. There's something wrong. There's something wrong with them.
Yeah, I know Jesse wants to replace them.
Yeah.
I mean, I think they're pretty well.
Pretty well shot.
Yeah, pretty well shot. And I did not check their rise and run, but I do know that they're.
It's good to do at the same time.
It would be good to do it at the same time. I think he may want to do it sooner rather than later, though. And I don't quite know how all that, what his real plan is there. But if we can, we would do it at the same time. This project is not a foregone conclusion that Buddy's can, you know, so we're trying to see if we can get the permits to do it. And then there's some negotiations between Jesse and Buddy's as to whether they can financially make it work.
Have you thought at all about the ramp?
I haven't thought too hard about the ramp.
That would give you a ramp into the building that exists now, right?
Well, that's the point of it, yeah. My thought is the ramp, what I have thought without doing any hard drawing is that it would probably be some sort of switchback that would allow to enter that landing that's at the top of the stairs there, level. I think that's close to a 5-foot radius at the top of the stairs. I don't know that, but that's my hope.
You could figure all that out at the same time.
Yeah, well that's, yes. I just didn't have time to do that.
The bulkhead?
Yeah, we're gonna cover that right up.
Where's the bulkhead?
It's to the right of the stairs as you go in there.
Oh, I see it.
You
yeah,
can sort
yeah,
of
yeah.
see that photograph there.
So we're just, the deck would be on top of it?
Yeah.
Other question I have. Has Chris talked all about the grading you're talking about? Because that's very climbable by kids. And usually they don't like that.
Yeah, no, I don't think he cares about that. You know, I did all the railings at Asiana that are all horizontal. There's no code that precludes. Just as long as you can't get a 4-inch sphere, they don't care if it's vertical or horizontal.
Okay. Don't attach iPads to it.
Right, no iPads.
No, that's good, you know, that's building code and insurance recommendations also for inch spacing.
Yep.
Anything commercial residential is fine, as long as it meets that.
Yep.
Can't remember the shape of the building exactly, the roof line, but does, if you had the ramp here, right?
Yep.
Is that a?
That's the gable end.
It's the gable end, though, that's better, yeah, okay.
Yep.
Remember, because it goes up on that sign that's going across.
That's right, the signs up there, yes, I do remember now, yeah.
You're getting a look at their new sign.
So just counting the risers, seven risers, two, three, four, I'm sorry, five risers, it's 7 inches by 35, so about 36 inches, so you need 36 feet of ramp.
Yeah, it's a big ramp.
So you'd have to start at the stairs and go up and probably come back to.
Yeah, I haven't.
To make that.
I haven't dove into it, but yeah.
The other thing you can do with a bulkhead, and actually we've built one of those, is you just have framing so that you can have a folding.
Yeah, we'll probably.
The deck itself actually hinges up and opens up so you can access the bulkhead if you need to get anything down.
Yeah.
Last thing you wanna do is have to start pulling the screws out in the middle of January.
Right, chopping joists.
To get some new equipment in the basement.
Right, exactly.
I would almost think about doing, coming at the ramp from the other side. From out towards closer to Berry, go to Berry Street, do a switchback over on that side. I think the problem with that is losing parking, you know, there's a lot of parking.
And come in the front door, you're saying?
No, just move the ramp to the Berry Street side of the current entry.
I think that's what I was thinking.
Right, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, to the side, switch back over here, but still entering through the front door.
Yeah. So as you're going up the stairs, on the left-hand side to the Berry Street side, is where I was thinking it would go. There is like a strip of green there that isn't necessarily parking, it's not very big.
Parking's always been an issue there.
Yeah, at the moment, it's basically proposed to go basically over where the snowbank was and not lose any parking. If you can sort of see in that photograph where the grubby gross snowbank is, it's basically where the deck goes.
There's gonna be lots of outdoor dining in Montpelier.
Trying.
It's climate change, I guess that's.
Yeah.
Right.
The other thing, I know it's an additional expense, but you may need the provision for it if he doesn't do it at the same time as the ramp, is that with this roof line here, it might be possible to extend that roof line out over the ramp so that any weather gets diverted away from the ramp as well.
Yep.
I mean, it could be, the design could be incorporated into this little bump out here and the overhang over the stairs. And then, you know, again, you could create some kind of a roof line covering part, not all of the ramp.
Yeah, I wonder, yeah, as long as it stays above the windows that aren't drawn in there, but yeah.
Just a thought.
Yeah.
Or at least allow a provision for it so that if you've
could
got
be added.
You know, if you've got some sonotubes or something mounted that will provide additional support for at a future time.
Yep.
Okay, so you get the roof, that's the east side of the roof, so you get all the snow dumping down where the ramp was on the Berry Street side that I suggested, right?
Over here? You mean in here?
Yeah.
Well, the roof line here is like this, so it dumps
Yeah, I mean, 'cause I don't have a ramp drawn on here, I don't feel like that's a complete application, but, it's,
Do you wanna do that as a separate application, or would you just like to table this and then come back with a ramp idea? Your call.
Yeah.
Right, you could add, like, you could table, we could table this to the next meeting or the meeting after, and you could come back with a revised drawing showing the ramp, or you could just have that as a separate application whenever, you know, and move forward with the seating area without the ADA ramp. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It seems to me that with the steps in bad shape and having to put a ramp in this end, that there really needs to be some integrated planning to make it work. But I'm fine with it, I don't care if it's tabled or.
Yeah. I mean, I think the ramp should be made to look like the deck, so it all kinda is one unified thing. And again, I don't, it's not guaranteed that this project is going forward, so the steps are probably need to be done. This is, who knows if it can actually happen, but Jesse would love to see it happen, so. I guess, to me, it probably makes sense to table it and come back with the ramp.
Okay, again, that's your call, whatever.
And when you're working there, you don't have to go far for lunch?
That's true. I don't know if, it seems like people understand what's going on there enough, that front, it's, you know, this is proposed to be, left as it is, a galvanized looking thing, and then the kind of bar that runs across the top of it would also be like a bent galvanized kind of, just sort of like place to set your burger and your shake while you're eating.
Just stand up, or would they have tables, or?
There would be, one, or, in the back area would be tables, and then in front would be all kind of stools, it would be looking out on that beautiful parking lot.
So that's sort of a short bar, like an 18-inch?
Yep, yep.
Maybe?
Yep.
16, 18?
Something like that, yeah.
Big enough for a plate of pizza.
You got it.
Any lighting?
No lighting than what's already there.
Again, if you decide to, you know, they want any additional lighting, you know, throw something in, if you're gonna table it, throw something in.
Yeah.
Just as a possibility.
Right, and then we can.
In case they wanna add it, you know, you have, like, 2 years after.
Right, okay, great, yeah, we'll do that.
So they can add it in a year from when they do that, if they decide, well, it's really nice, but we'd really like to be open a little bit longer.
Right, throw some lights out there.
So throw some lights out.
Sure, that's a great idea, we'll do that.
Okay, we'll table it, do I hear a motion to table the application, or will, second?
Second.
All in favor of table? We'll see you at the next meeting.
All right. Great.
I don't know whether you're gonna stay or not, but one of the things I wanted to.
Yeah.
Make sure everybody was aware of our Wednesday night meeting.
Yep.
And hope everybody can attend.
Yep.
Yeah, at 6:30, the HPC is sponsoring their first, like, kind of kickoff meeting to update, the design review regulations, and our consultant will be there, he'll provide a basic overview of design review and historic preservation in the district and answer questions. And then, we hope just to have kind of an open discussion and ask people to tell their, like, little stories about, what they love about Montpelier, or a special, like, memory, or a special place, or anything like that, so. And just to get people's comments and feedback.
I think.
We'll have cookies too, and cider.
I think your, bank deck is a good example of what can get through design review.
Yeah.
I mean, people say it's gonna stop me from doing anything, and if you could talk about that for 2 minutes, that'd be great.
Sure, be happy to, yeah.
Which project was that?
The, the Asian.
The Asiana House.
The deck on Elm and.
Oh, right.
I mean, it is amazing, sort of, I get a lot of feedback from people of, how did that ever get through design review? They love it, and they think it's great, but we have this horrible reputation of, like,
Right.
stopping every project, which.
most of it undeserved.
Makes no sense.
Go back and look at the last 3 or 4 years, I think you'll find that very different.
I have, well, I mean, yeah, I.
But, yeah.
But there are a lot of people who have long memories.
Yeah.
I think that the purpose of this, I chair the Preservation Commission, and I want to have a really open process so nobody can come in and say, well, I didn't know about that, I didn't have a chance for input. And we're purposely doing the input right at the onset. We haven't even drawn the boundaries yet.
Yep.
I don't know how much things are gonna change. I think currently it works pretty well, but a lot of people think it doesn't. So.
There was that got canceled because of a snowstorm. Some guy that was doing a TED talk about sort of.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That's rescheduled for June.
June,
yep.
Okay.
Like
great.
Creating a sense of place and sense of community and stuff.
Yeah,
like
and just
that.
Sort of
that
like an intentionality
yeah.
around
yeah,
creating
totally.
Your place.
Yeah.
That seemed like a really good thing. I was sorry it got canceled.
Mm-hmm.
So, good it's in June.
Good. Great. Thank you.
Why don't we move on to the minutes? And for June the 19th.
I will
present.
Move. I want to move those. You don't have the year right, though. You don't have the year. Those are like 10 months old, right?
They're old.
Yeah.
Because we haven't had the same
right.
three people
well,
here.
It's been that. It's
but now we do.
Yeah.
Haven't had a list. So we need
this
the three
this
of you to take a look
at that.
Maybe
gets in the Guinness Book of longest lived minutes.
The three of you take a look at it, and if you like it, somebody make a motion to approve.
Well, my memory is so fresh from last June that let me see.
No,
I'm not sure about the spelling of that word, or
I wasn't there. But
he's actually exactly right.
Yeah, I think I
looked
over them too previously.
You have numerous chances.
There was a lot of
the
agenda that day. No, I know.
They do look really familiar, so. I would move to approve these minutes.
I'll second.
All in favor of approving the June the 19th?
Yay.
Yay. Approved.
Anyway.
I don't want to let him go now.
And then we have Monday, March the 19th, which was not too long ago.
I wasn't here for that. I had another meeting.
So, Liz, myself,
they came back with pretty good drawings so you could understand what was.
Oh, this was the
Van Door. Motion to approve?
So I'll move to approve.
A second.
Second. All in favor of the minutes for March the 19th? They are approved.
Wow.
We cleared the board.
All right. Don't we have any other outstanding minutes?
And then I had the election of chair and vice chair. We were supposed to do it back in January, but I forgot to put it on the agenda until now, so.
Did we hear nominations from before?
I'll nominate Steve as chair.
Where'd you come up with that crazy idea?
Mostly because I don't want to be.
So. He does such a good job reading through
yes.
all the
well,
criteria.
Try to keep
his handwriting's good too much.
It's spotty, it's inconsistent.
I second that motion.
And do we want to nominate a vice chair? I'll return the favor to Eric and nominate Eric as vice chair.
I that's okay. I'm gonna probably quit one.
I'll second that.
Okay, all in favor of Eric as vice chair. Raise your hand. No changes.
And then the next meeting is April 16th. And I'm not sure what's on the agenda so far. I don't think we have any, well, I guess this project, if you're ready for that.
I'll try and get ready.
Other than that, I don't know of any others that are on the agenda. I did meet with an applicant today that they might come through for a informal kind of feedback, but I'm not sure if it'll be ready for the 16th.
Okay.
I'm gonna stick around for development review.
Okay, does anybody have any other comments, questions, or anything to add?
Wednesday, 6:30 in this room?
Yep, yep. And we're not expecting like a really late meeting or anything like that. We hope to have it like tops like an hour, hour and a half or something like that, so. And if you can only stay for a few minutes, don't feel obligated to stay for the whole thing, but.
The thing that, the way the city set this up, I don't know how this happened. I think the planning commission is, you know, the historic preservation commission writes the rules for design review. And I don't really like that very much. Yeah, I want design review to be a real part of this rule writing. And we're gonna have a pretty open process. We're gonna have some working sessions. I think the current thing works pretty well, but I think we want to be a little clearer and try to set some, try to do some definitions of, what is compatible, so that it's a little more, it's more clear to the applicant. I think that's really what we're going is to say, it's to make things easier for the applicant and what we're looking for.
David Raphael, right? That's,
yeah,
he's
yeah.
pretty good at, I think, at
yeah, he's
visuals.
You know, yeah, he's and he's got some pictures that Sarah sent and he's obviously going to be an advocacy for design review. I'm going to invite Ben Hoffman.
Good.
So.
Good.
That's good, and some other people. So. And Sarah's done a great job of sending stuff to the planning commission and the mayor, the new mayor and all of that, so.
Good.
Yeah, we hope for a good turnout.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else have anything to add? Do we hear a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor of adjournment, raise your hand. Meeting is adjourned.
Thank you.